Hi all, welcome to the brand new episode of Money Works For Me podcast. We are recording this session on Tuesday, September 7th, 2021. I am Aditya and with me I have our equity analyst Ketan. Hello Ketan.
Hi everyone.
Today we are going to discuss about auto sector, risk and opportunities. To start with Ketan, what is Money Works For Me view on auto sector?
Auto sector forms a very large percentage of India's GDP. Directly or indirectly, it contributes around 10 to 12% of total GDP.
Okay.
As incomes and aspiration of Indian population grows, we are naturally going to see long-term growth in auto sector.
Mm-hmm.
But at the same time, we must be cognizant of the fact that auto sector will be going through a massive disruption over next decade. In past, India had few phenomenal companies which were very successful and highly profitable. If you had bought them and held them for years, you would have made huge returns.
Okay.
But the landscape is now changing very fast in favor of companies that are coming up with electric vehicles with more or less similar scale as old players.
Mm-hmm.
Now, just to retain the market share and existing profits, the incumbents will have to invest massively into new technology, or they will have to acquire emerging players.
Right.
We believe that this will lead to deterioration in the profits in the medium term. So we will remain cautious on quite a few of auto companies today.
By that, do you mean IC engines will become obsolete?
In reality, IC engines are here to stay, as the change will happen slowly over a decade. However, the incremental growth will be largely in electric vehicles, which makes us cautious on incumbent companies. We have largely avoided the auto and auto ancillary space, which can become value trap, where their profits will stay flat till the time they pivot their existing business to new age business model.
Okay, so does India have enough players in the auto and auto ancillary space to benefit from the EV story?
Whenever a new industry emerges, it takes time to get the entire supply chain ready for new products and new way of doing business.
Okay.
As of now, none of the players are ready for electric vehicles. Today, it is more important to identify which players will not get affected by electric vehicles as opposed to the one who will benefit.
Correct.
Only time will tell which ones will be able to benefit from the new trend in EV.
So, how to identify winners and losers within the automobile sector going forward, considering the cyclical nature of this sector?
I think it's very hard to identify the emerging winners at the nascent stage of any emerging sector. Instead, we must look at greener pastures where the profitability will remain intact despite disruption. Now, these are the companies which sell premium motorcycles or a tractor or commercial vehicles where the EV threat is quite less. So we see that the companies like Eicher Motors and Mahindra, where we are invested, these companies may face limited disruption. In the ancillary space, companies in tires and lighting might face limited disruption as well. Now, there are few direct beneficiaries that can enjoy incremental growth from electric vehicles like Sona Comstar. In terms of identifying the losers, we will continue to avoid stocks in two-wheeler or three-wheeler, even four-wheeler space. They will need massive investments in electric vehicle manufacturing, which will lead to poor cash flow growth over next decade. At the same time, the battery industry can also face disruption because they may not be able to scale up their business for the new automobile era.
Alright, so most investors think battery manufacturers like Exide and Amara Raja will benefit the most from the EV revolution. What's your take on that?
Firstly, Amara Raja and Exide manufacture lead batteries, which are only used for ignition and lightning.
Mm-hmm.
Now today, entire car will be run on lithium-ion batteries, which is completely new technology.
Right.
Batteries form significant part of total cost of building an automobile.
Mm.
Now, this is likely to be manufactured in-house or in partnership with peers. We have already seen that Maruti and Toyota have signed up to manufacture batteries together.
Right.
This is going to require massive investment to achieve scale, which will run into several million dollars.
Mm.
We find that companies like Amara Raja or Exide Industries are not relevant in next generation of automobile industry. They will continue to supply lead batteries, but the growth rates will be very low as they can't benefit directly from electric vehicles. Their balance sheets simply cannot support the kind of investments new age batteries require.
Okay. So, alright. Thank you everyone for joining this podcast. Thank you, Ketan, for your valuable inputs. To all the listeners, You can subscribe to our channel to get frequent updates on market, stocks and sectors. And if you want us to discuss any specific topic, do let us know in the comment section. Till then, happy investing.